Hello guys, this is Trisha with another motivational moment today. My topic is about me, a little bit about me. I want to tell you guys just a little bit about me. You guys may know a little bit, you don't know all about me. Well, I am a motivational speaker. I've been a motivational speaker now, whole 4 years now. I used to go out and talk to people in churches. I used to talk to people in a nursing home. My job outside of YouTube is I'm a counselor. I counsel little kids. I like what I do. You know, I've been doing it some years now, you know, and I'm enjoying it. The reason why I joined YouTube is to make it better for people. You know, there's a lot of people going through so much, and you know, we just don't know what they're going through. And I was always the type, was a loving, giving, caring person, you know. And God, I think, believe this is my calling, because you know what? I've been wanting to be a motivational speaker for a very, very long time, but you know what? I strayed away from it, and God already told me, hey, that is your calling, girl. Go ahead out there, speak to people, teach people the word, give them the word. So God told me, go ahead out there and be a leader. So I decided to take a leap of faith like we usually scared to do. But you know, when God calls you to do something, go out and do it. Don't be afraid to take a leap of faith, because you just never know where it's going to lead you to. So I decided talking to people in the nursing homes, older people, you know, people, you know, they're lonely in a nursing home and they need you. They need you. They need to be around people that's going to uplift them, encourage them, say, hey, it's okay. It's okay. You know, and I'm that girl, you know, and I've always been that type of woman to help people, to motivate people, and to give. God wants us to give people. We don't do that enough because we're so busy being stingy with people, being, feeling like we the world owe us something, but really the world doesn't owe us anything. So like I said, so I start going to churches and talking. I start going to nursing home and talking. I'm going to, you know, just different places and talking to people, speaking to people. And they was like, why haven't you became a motivational speaker? So I decided to become a motivational speaker and talk to people on YouTube. That's who's broken, who's hurting, who's, you know, just needs someone around to talk to. And I said, I'm that girl. They can count on me. So I decided to call my channel Trisha Motivational Moment, when everybody usually say Trisha Motivational Movement. But you know what? I said, you know what? Everybody say that. I might as well change my name to Trisha Motivational Movement, because everybody I come in contact always say Trisha Motivational Movement when it's Trisha Motivational Moment. So I decided to get on YouTube and start talking to people. And start encouraging people. Start uplifting people. You just never know who needs to hear from you. You never know who needs to hear, you know, you, about you. So I decided to do that. And, you know, I just got encouraging, give people encouraging words. And, you know, go on from there. You know, people don't want to do that anymore, because they're today for themselves. One thing about me, I always put myself last. That's who I am. I always put myself last and I always put people first. God said we need to do that anyway. And I always done that anyway. Before I even was saved, I always put people first, give them my last. You know what? And all I ask for in return is a simple thank you. I'm a very kind-hearted person. I've always been a very kind-hearted person. You know what? I'm not bipolar. I'm not mean. All those things that I used to be, I'm not that anymore. You know, people don't get to know me. They judge. That's what you shouldn't do. You need to get to know Trisha or get to know the next person for who they are. So I'm a very, very kind-hearted person. You know, I'm not going to change up on you. When you come to my live stream, I'm going to always welcome you with a kind word. Hello, how are you doing? You know, something just to let you know that I do care. And I do care about people. I wasn't always a people person. I was always like a private person to myself. But as I got a little older and a little wiser, I became a people person, because the job that I do outside of YouTube allows me for me to be a people person. I have to talk to people. I have to talk to different people. So I had to learn to interact with people to be a people person. Believe it or not, I always was a very, very shy person. Very shy. You wouldn't tell by listening to me on my live stream, but I was always a very, very shy person. I learned to get away from that and, you know, just start being outgoing and talking to people. So that's what I do now. I talk to people. I encourage people to move on. Don't worry about what people say about you. Don't worry about how people feel about you. You have to keep on going, because if you stop when people talk about you, if you stop when people don't like you, you'll never grow. So I learned to take one day at a time and do what I do. And I do it to the best of my ability. I know what I do, and I know I do a great job. I don't ask for nobody to tell me what I'm doing, because God already told me what I'm doing. So as long as God told me what I'm doing, that I'm doing an amazing job, I'm going to keep on going. I'm going to keep on pushing. Like I said, I am not from Atlanta, Georgia. I am from New York City, upstate New York City, that is. But I moved away from New York City some years ago, and I start living in Columbus, Ohio. And I love Columbus, Ohio. The reason why I moved from Columbus, Ohio, because I wanted better for myself. And plus, it was just too cold for me. So I say I'm going to move to Atlanta, Georgia. I don't know why I did that, make that mistake to move to Atlanta, Georgia, because I really don't like Atlanta, Georgia, but I'm here until God tell me somewhere that I need to go. But it ain't going to be no California. It ain't going to be no here. It's not going to go back to Columbus. But it's probably going to end up being Florida. That's where I'm, you know, that's where I want to go. You know, it's up to God. Wherever God leads me to, that's where I'm going to go. But basically, it's not going to be here. This is not going to be where I'm going to grow old at. You know, I want to go somewhere and I want to get stable. I want to be happy. Because, you know, you don't want to be somewhere that you're not happy. Here, I'm not happy. You know, and I try and try to be happy. I've been here in Atlanta, Georgia, 3 long, miserable years. But I'm not happy. So I want to move on to somewhere that I'm going to be happy, that I'm going to, you know, just love who I am. You know, when you're someplace where you don't love the place, you start feeling bad about yourself. You start feeling like, wow, this is never going to change. But we don't want to think that's nothing going to change, because it is. God has got you. God is with you. And God is going to lead you in the right direction. So that's what I wait on God to lead me into the right direction. Right now, this is not the right direction for me. This is not where I want to be. This is not where I want to stand still. I want to move on to better. I want to do better with my life. So if I want to do better in my life, I got to get around somebody that's going to encourage me to keep going. Because sometimes, just because I'm a motivational speaker, sometimes I feel like just giving up. You know, but you know why I don't. I keep going because, you know, when you're in a place that you don't like, you don't want to be there, you feel like wow, the world is all you just closing in on the world. So you know what? I don't want to think that way. So like I said, yeah, I am a motivational speaker. I've been doing it now for 4 years. You know, I'm uplifting people, encouraging people, letting people know it's okay to cry. It's okay to be sad. You know, some people are going to tell you it's not okay to be sad. But let me tell you something. We're human. We're not perfect. We're going to cry. We're going to get miserable. We're going to get stressed out. We're going to get depressed. That is what is called a part of life. It's life. And I had to learn that. Just because I'm a motivational speaker doesn't mean I don't get upset. Doesn't mean that I don't cry. Doesn't mean I don't get depressed, because we all are human. So I moved here 3 years ago. I became a motivational speaker, and I've been here since, and I'm working at my job and doing this part-time, doing this thing right here. But like I said, I want this to go somewhere, this motivational speaker stuff. This is just a platform for me right now. This is not a real big stepping stone right now. So I'm taking this day as a platform. I haven't got nowhere yet with this, but like I said, as long as I keep on going and keep on going, and keep on going, I plan to do bigger things out of what I'm doing right now. You know, sometimes we have to start small before we get to the bigger thing. Sometimes God put us small before we get to the bigger thing. But some people don't even want to go small before they get to the bigger thing. I know this is small right now for me. I know where God is taking me to. As long as I spoke it into existence and I know and I agree with what God say, I'm going to do bigger things. I'm going to do better things. But we do have to crawl sometime before we walk. There's a lot of people don't want to crawl before they walk. They want to just jump right into it. You can't not just jump right into something, because it doesn't happen like that. If it happened like that, everybody would be following their dream. Everybody would be happy. Nobody would be sad. But since it doesn't fall that way, we have to wait on God to lead us to that next path, to that next generation, to that next chapter. Right now, this is just a book. The book haven't been opened yet. I'm just telling you a little bit about me, because God is going to open that book up so you guys can know really, really about me. You guys going to remember my name one day. I know that for sure. But right now, I got to keep on uplifting you guys. I got to keep on encouraging you guys. Don't give up whatever you do in life. Wherever life is taking you, just don't give up. Keep on trying to be a winner because we are winners. So what I'm trying to say is, guys, I have three children, three wonderful children, one girl and two boys. With my kids with me, everybody think my kids, my sons, are my boyfriend. I say, no, these are my sons. And my sons get so mad when people say, that's not my girlfriend. That is my mom. Stop trying to get on my mom. That's my mom. I told him, boy, you should be happy somebody complimenting your mom, you know, but my sons are like that. My daughter, she's a very, very spoiled young lady. She stays here with me. She have my granddaughter. I have four grandkids. People wouldn't believe it. My kids made me a grandma very, very early. But you know, I don't regret being a grandma. I love being a grandma. You know what? There's a lot of people wish they was a grandma. But me, I'm glad I'm a grandma. I'm glad I got to see my little kids, my little grandbabies, you know. So yeah, I'm glad to do that. Yeah, so I got three kids. I got four grandkids. I got two girls and two boys. Isn't that amazing? So, you know, I spoil them all the same. You know, I love them all the same. You know, there's no difference in the who's who. But like I said, the little one that stays here, she drives me up the wall. But you know what? I can't do nothing but to love her. So, yeah. So that's a little bit about me. You know, it's not too much to know about me. My birthday just passed. It was in November. I celebrated. I went out for my birthday. I had a good time. You know, like I said, the more I get older, I don't really like celebrating my birthday much. I thank God that I got a year older. I thank God for that. But being like celebrating it, going out and doing stuff, I don't do that no more. I used to, but I don't do it as much as I used to anymore. But you know, I thank God for blessing me to see another year. I thank God for still God allowing me to be here, to be able to talk to you guys, to tell you guys a little bit about my life. You know what? My life wasn't always ice cream and cake. My life wasn't always the way it is. Now, I had my struggles. I had my ups and downs. But you know what? I keep on going. I keep on believing in myself. Not only in myself, I believe in God. And I know God is going to help me through the good time. I know God is going to help me through the bad time. But I got to keep on going, keep on growing, keep on going there. Just keep going where you're going. I don't know where this life is going to take me, but God only knows what is best for me. I always say what God has for me is for me. And I always got to remember that what God has for me is for me. Nobody on this platform, nobody on YouTube can take that away from me. Only God can. So what I do, I just sit down and continue on striving, continue on grinding, continue on going where God wants me to go. And as long as I'm doing what God wants me to do, being a leader, not a follower, as long as I'm teaching you guys some good word, letting you know, hey, get it right before the end of time comes, I'm going to be okay. God loves people to teach people things that they doesn't know. There's things that I don't know. It's good to be teach stuff that you don't know from other people. Don't take it offended when somebody teach you something that you don't know. Because I don't know everything. You don't know everything. So it's good to be teach. And I like people to tell me something that I didn't know. So I can say, wow, I'm going to put that with my stuff. You know, you want to learn different stuff from people. You don't want to act like you know everything because we don't know everything. It's good to get teach something, you know. So what, like I said, yeah. So I've been here in Atlanta. Only thing I like about Atlanta is the weather. The weather is beautiful here. I have not really wore a big coat in a very, very long time. It's like jacket all the time or a little bit thicker than a jacket, but a big old coat, a scarf and all that stuff, you don't wear that in here in Atlanta. When I first moved to Atlanta, I seen a little coating of snow. After that, I haven't seen no much snow. My granddaughter never seen snow before because we moved right here when she was a little, little baby. So she really don't know nothing about no snow. So when she do see some snow, oh my goodness, she gonna have a fit. So yeah, it's get a little bit of coating snow here, not much. So when I seen that, people here in Atlanta, they had their shovels and everything, and they closed down the schools here in Atlanta. When you get a little bit of snow here, just a drip, something you can just sweep away with a broom, they closed down the schools. We were driving in it. We didn't think nothing of it, but everybody here around us thought it was something bad. Why are you guys driving that fast? Because where I come from, New York City, Columbus, Ohio, we get snow. We get black ice. We get it all. So I'm used to driving in that type of stuff. It didn't faze me now, you know. So I learned to drive. I learned to do what they do here. If the schools were shut down, you know, hey, they were shut down. So I was like, wow. You know, I had to get used to that. I was like, wow, they shut down the school for a little bit, stuff like that. But you know what? That's Atlanta for you. But other than that, the hospitality here in Atlanta is amazing. They greet you. They greet you really nice. So I like that about Atlanta. But I'm going to close this up for now. Oh, I have my mother. She's still living. She stays in Ohio. My father, he's dead. I was always a daddy's girl, y'all know. But like I said, yeah, my mom is still living. We are very, very close. I have three brothers and one more sister. You know, very, very close to my sister, too. And one of my brothers, too. So, hey, you know, that's just a little bit about me, guys. I'm glad. I'm hoping you guys liked it, my little conversation with you guys about me and about Atlanta and about my life. Make sure you give this video a big old thumbs up. Make sure you like and subscribe if you're not a family of mine. And guess what, guys? At the end of the day, don't forget to smile. Do not let nobody take you out your character. Do not let nobody steal your joy. Don't let nobody tell you that you are not nobody. Because guess what? You matter and you are somebody. So guess what? Continue on smiling. Continue on believing in yourself. And continue on loving yourself. Thank you guys for listening. Bye. Thank you.